But we did the fender shop the other day. We got the Rubicon fender flares on Ryan's Jeep and they look fantastic. However, that was only half of the install. So after you put the fender chops on or chop your factory Wrangler, you're gonna need to put either lights or front brackets up here. We needed full turn signals. We were gonna buy the Motobilt fender chop brackets, but they only have a marker light in there. And in the state of Pennsylvania, we needed the full turn signals and stiffen also this fender flare up. That's step one of this video, to get the fender chop bracket on. And then in our case, get the DRL and the turn signals installed. We've got the inner fenders coming here. They'll be here later today, and that'll be in this video too. Without further ado, let's unbox this, because we actually reached out to a company called Infinite Off-Road. Now, Wayne, who's a follower and friend of the channel, he runs their lights on his 392 and has had great success with them. So we decided to reach out and say, hey, we're gonna order a set of these. You know, what do you recommend? So they said, hey, we've got a cool set of smoked front DRL turn signals that we think would look great on Ryan's Jeep. Now I'll pull the first one out here. And check that out, guys. So this is a fully smoked out front DRL turn signal. It's got the brackets here on the side, as well as a full underside bracket that is made out of metal. And this helps stiffen up the front end of the fender. As you can see, when this goes on here, this outside of the fender is pretty floppy. But when you put this in and get it bolted onto the bracketry, it really helps stiffen it up, and it bolts onto two factory locations. The one thing I liked about this kit is that a lot of these require you to drill a hole out here. So like, you've got to drill right into the side of here to mount this. Infinite Off-Road actually uses an aluminum piece of angle there with 3M on the back, and that's what sticks to the corner of your inner fender to this piece. I kind of like that, just in case you ever do go back and forth, Ryan, you're not drilling a hole in the side of your brand new painted fender flare. But in my opinion, I do like the look of these smoked ones. And Ryan just brought up a valid point. These will match your rear tail lights. So your tail lights are smoked. These are going to be smoked up front, and they'll have your running light as well as a front turn signal. The one thing I will note before you put this in, on the inside here, there's a little bit that you're gonna have to trim off. So right about here, you'll wanna trim this back a little bit. And you can do this as much or as little as you need, just kind of keep putting the light up and down. But I just grabbed a sharp razor knife and just trim this back. And also there's a clip there that we had to pull off too, so we just cut that off. But if you just take a razor knife, you can get in here and just kind of trim it back as you need. And then I like to just keep testing it, right? So just keep testing it, trim it off, and just slip it over those brackets. This front edge will kind of sit behind there. That looks cool. Yeah. Doesn't it look good, Ryan? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the included stainless hardware here and use it on the bottom bracket. Put that up through, put a washer and a lock nut on top, and you're gonna use a 13 mil wrench and a 13 mil socket to get that done. So you're gonna have one of the bolts that goes up through down here, and then one that goes up through right here. Those are the two factory brackets on these. So using a 13 millimeter socket and a box wrench, don't worry, like I said, don't worry about it falling. You gotta snug some of this stuff up. I started both of them. That would have been an expensive fail there, Ryan, slipping that wrench into your camera lens. I'm just gonna snug this one up and see as it's pulling up, just then you can adjust it out here. So as it's pulling up and as you're tightening it, you'll start to see where your adjustments need to be made to get it really perfect. But it's actually pulling up your fender too, Ryan, which is nice. You can feel the structure like getting back to what it should be. And then we'll tighten up the back one too. Get them nice and snugged up. And then on the outside, that's where you use this aluminum piece. So a lot of the other kind of other chops will have you drill a hole through here and have a bracket. Now you could do this, we could put a little angle bracket on here, but for this, you can see that this doesn't have any structure out here. So you're just gonna take this piece on the inside of the fender, just like so, and push it against the fender and then push it down. So that way it holds it on with 3M. Now you could do this more permanent, but I kind of like this. And the fact if the 3M ever decides to rip apart, you still have a lot of other structure there, so I'm not too concerned. And we can just replace the 3M or drill it fast, but they have a 25-year warranty with these. I called them on the phone and they're like, yeah, everything has a 25-year warranty, so. And then it actually says in the instructions, if you want, you can take like a small C-clamp here and put soft cloth on both sides and just let it hold there for like an hour or so. But we don't have a small C-clamp right now out in the shop. I think there's one at my house, but yeah, that's all you have to do. And then basically to get them connected, you plug it into the harness here. So this plugs into the harness, and then this already has the factory plug here. And I'm gonna take these and I'm gonna end up zip tying them all nicely, but just plug it back here, Ryan, into your factory location. You'll hear a little click, and that's it. Are they on?
Yeah.
So they're, with the smoke, they're a little bit less illuminated than like a clear one because you have a smoked lens. That's just like your taillights in the back. But a nice crisp all the way across. I mean, they look nice. And then let's fire up your four ways here just so we can see both of them running at once. Yeah, it looks really good. I'll shut off the lights in the shop here. We can see if there are any. They're gonna be bright at night. I like, it's kind of a smooth LED though. That looks good. The sequential is cool. That I wasn't sure if they were gonna be sequential or not. I probably should have looked that up, but. And they wrap around the side too. So it works as your side marker, see that? So if you actually see that on the side, Ryan, you know how your factory turn signal has the side one? So that still counts as your side turn signal. So you can kind of see, guys, just how much structure this gives you back. Like, it's not just moving around like it was before. Now, obviously, back here, it's sturdy back here. Yeah. It just, it gives it so much more up front and then gives you a working turn signal again, which is exactly what you needed. I'm very happy with the looks of these. I've seen some smoked ones. We've seen these all over. We didn't know which brand to go with, but I gotta say, I'm happy with the way that these turned out. All right, guys, well, obviously we are not in the same location that we just installed the Fender Chop light brackets. We're actually down at Locked and Loaded 4x4 the day before Jeep Beach. We've had a ton going on. When I say a ton, you guys saw all the Jeep content coming out on my 392. We had to wait for some other parts to come in and then also kind of carve out some time to do this. But Ryan's Jeep is up on the rack here. You can see underneath here, we've got all this bare and exposed. Luckily, he hasn't been driving too much with it because it definitely is a little bit more exposed and weak underneath here. You don't want all this getting sprayed with mud and debris. So we do have a set of Motobilt inner fenders for both the front and the rear of the Jeep. We're gonna be installing them today, and I think it's gonna turn out really cool. But that's the second part of a fender chop. Once you do the chop like this, you've gotta add a light on the front or something, unless you add some different headlights, and then you've gotta do some inner fenders because you do not want all this exposed. We're gonna get these installed. Alex is gonna help us out, and yeah, we'll show you how they look. Initially, we were gonna try and run the high clearance inner fenders that I had on mine just to speed up Ryan's process a little bit. The fronts would have fit fine. These are a little bit different as the 40 inch plus clearance kit. You can see all in here is this all gonna be vented. So that'll be really nice to let some of that heat out of the engine bay. But on the rears, they were a little bit different. So we opted to go for the standard inner fenders for Ryan's Jeep. But overall, it looks the same. These two holes right up here are gonna line up on the top of that inner structure, and then this one on the subframe as well. These three will get drilled out, and then that'll actually attach onto the secondary piece and just go on to kind of that inner fender section. Up here also, this one goes on its own bracket and gets rib nutted. The bracket gets rib nutted to the frame to an existing hole. So not too crazy hard. If you guys watched ours, it's pretty much the same process, but we just wanted to show a little tidbits of it today. All right, guys, check it out. So this one is wrapped up on the front. You can see that vent that we were just talking about, how nice that is. You're actually gonna get a lot of cooling out of the engine bay through that. All the nutserts are installed. You have five on this. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and well, actually there's only four. Well, five, there's one in the frame rail. I forgot about that. But look at how clean these look. Motobilt is the way to go when it comes to these inner fender replacements. They look awesome. They give us a ton of clearance, and then they just really finish up the look for Ryan. Plus, protect everything that's behind there. You don't want all that just getting beat up by the rain, snow, and salt coming in there. You want something to protect it, and these are gonna do a fantastic job. So these are done. We gotta do the other side and then the rear. The rear is a heck of a lot easier. No nutserts, and we'll just keep going. The nice thing about the rear inner fenders, there's no rib nuts to actually attach these here. So Alex has got everything bolted up. You do have to pre-assemble these on the floor or on the work table before you install them, but they got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that actually hold it to the tub of the vehicle. These look fantastic. They do a really good job at actually bending these and getting them to give you the maximum clearance. Now back at our shop, we did try the high clearance ones without the high clearance fenders, and they did not work. So you have to kind of have those in order to get the high clearance fenders to work. But these look fantastic on the back. They're gonna do a great job at, once again, protecting everything back here, protecting the fuel filler neck and all that good stuff, but then also just cleaning up the look of it. So these look really good, and you need this with a fender chop. You've gotta kind of clean it up underneath there. On today's viewer rig of the video, we're checking out Sean's 2012 Jeep Wrangler Arctic Edition 2-door. This is a rare Jeep. He says one of only 1,100 special edition JKs made in the year 2012. Features a really cool unique black vinyl hood decal, unique Speedo, two Yeti footprint decals on the hood and fender, white interior accents, and a couple other things on the inside of there. Now, he does have a 2.5-inch lift on this Jeep. Jeep, and you can tell that he really does go and take it out there. I see Colorado plates on it, and I can tell that he is having some fun with this Jeep. A set of 285 7017 Cooper Discoverers, AEV rear steel bumper, hard rock 4x4 bolt-in cage, an AEV snorkel, and even a Gobi Ranger rack up top that holds hella lights and limb risers. He said he kept everything kind of relatively close to stock, open diffs front and rear, but he will have some more upgrades here in the future. Sean, thank you for submitting your rig, and if you guys want to have a chance at your vehicle being featured, be sure to hit us up through Instagram or send us an email. Well guys, that's going to wrap it up for today's video. Obviously, this is the part two, so the first part was actually doing the fender chop and getting all that installed from Distinction Applied. Next, we added on a set of the Infinite Off-Road smoked LED brackets. I really do like these. They turned out really nice on the Jeep, and I like the fact that on the side, you don't have to use a bolt that goes through. You actually just 3M those on. But then on the inside, we had to add something to protect all of the inside of the engine bay and all those sensitive parts. So we went with the Motobilt inner fenders for both the front and the rear. Now what's nice about this is you get them fully aluminum, they're gonna look fantastic. You can powder coat them, you can paint them, you can do whatever you'd like. We left ours raw. That's kind of how I like to run them, and Ryan likes the look too. But with that black part, the lower part of the fender, you really, really open this up. There's a ton more clearance. We'll probably ditch these brackets here in the future too. We've got a ton of clearance and a lot more going on underneath this Jeep. I just think it looks fantastic. So the fender chop is complete. Part two is done. It took us a couple weeks, but through the magic of video editing, it'll all be one seamless video. I hope you guys enjoyed this though. We really like the look of this. Let us know down below in the comments if you guys like the fender chop look. I know a lot of you guys were giving me grief when I did the fender flare video because I said stock sport black fenders look dorky. Remind you, I said stock sport, not stock black Rubicon, just sport. You guys are ripping me apart about that. I meant the stock sport one, so let's settle down a little bit. I like these flares on Ryan's Jeep. He wanted the color match, so that's what we got, and I think it looks awesome. So until next time, my name's Matt, and that's Ryan from Dirt Road Cred, and we want you to get out there and earn yours.